Hello viewers, welcome to UN Digital Class. In today's lecture, I am going to discuss about natural language processing. Before going to the natural language processing, first of all, we have to know about what is the requirement of natural language processing in artificial intelligence. In artificial intelligence, you must know that the main aim of artificial intelligence is to design or to create an agent which behaves like human being and think like human being. That means in artificial intelligence, suppose we design a robot which perform a specific task. Suppose that task is to clean a room. That means when you design that robot, you must want that as per your instruction, the robot can perform its task. Which means when you give an instruction to that robot to clean the room, then that instruction must be in your own language or in your language that is the natural language like the English language. But here the robot cannot understood the English language because you must know that the machine or the system only understood the machine level language. That means here when you give the instruction to the robot in your own language or by using the natural language, then in this case the robot may not understood your instruction. For this purpose, we use the natural language processing. Here, the natural language processing converts the natural language into the machine language so that the robot or the machine can easily understood your instruction and as per your instruction it performs the task. This is the main aim of natural language processing in artificial intelligence. Now let us start. What is natural language processing? Natural language processing, or you can say it as NLP, referred to AI method of communicating with an intelligent systems using a natural language such as English, which means NLP is nothing but it is a method of communication in artificial intelligence. And this method is basically used when a human being wants to communicate with a robot or with a system. Next, processing of natural language is required when you want an intelligent system like robot to perform as per your instruction, and when you want to hear decision from a dialogue based clinical expert system and others. That means natural language processing is basically required when you want the robot can perform its task as per your instruction. In this case, the natural processing must be required. Next, the field of NLP involves making computers to perform useful tasks with the natural languages human use. That means the computer can easily understood the natural language by using the NLP system. And here the NLP system always takes the input and gives the output in the form of speech or the written text. Next, components of NLP. There are two components of NLP. First one is the natural language understanding, or you can say it as NLU. Here, the natural language understanding helps the machine to understand and analyze human language, which means the NLU is nothing but it is the one component of our NLP system. And the main aim of NLU is to understand the human language and analyze that language. Next, it involves the following tasks. First one is it is used to map the given input into a useful representation. Next, analyzing different aspects of the language. That means the NLU always performs the two tasks. First one is it takes the input and map into a useful representation. And here the input is in the form of natural language. Then second task is it analyzes the different aspects of the language. Next, the second component of our NLP. Here the second component is natural language generation, or you can call it as NLG. The natural language generation acts as a translator that converts the computerized data into natural language representation, which means here the natural language generation always takes the computer language or computerized data and convert it into the natural language. And this is basically used for the translation purpose or translating the computer language into the natural language. Next, it involves text planning, sentence planning and text realization. Now look at the text planning. In text planning, it includes retrieving the relevant content from the knowledge base. And in the sentence planning, it includes choosing required words, forming meaning phrases, setting tone of the sentence. And next one is the text realization. In text realization, it is mapping sentence plan into sentence structure, which means in natural language generation, when it translates the computer language into natural language, it always performs three things. First one is the text planning. In text planning, it retrieves the relevant content from the knowledge base of our system. Then next one is the sentence planning. In sentence planning, it takes the whole sentence, and from that sentence, it takes the phrases and the words. Then last one is the text realization. In text realization, it plans for the sentence, and after planning the sentence, it gives the output in natural language. Next, the NLU is harder than NLG. That means among the two components, that is the NLU, natural language understanding, and another one is the NLG, that is the natural language generation. In these two components, the NLU component is harder. Why this component is harder? Now look at the next slide. Difficulties in NLU. Here, NLU has an extremely rich form and structure, and it is very ambiguous. That means the natural language is a rich form and rich structure, and it always contains some ambiguity. Now look at the different level of ambiguity. Here the first level of ambiguity is lexical ambiguity. That is, it is at very primitive level, such as word level ambiguity. For example, treating the word board as noun or verb. That means the lexical analysis is nothing but it is a word level ambiguity. Suppose you are taking a word that is board, and you think that whether this word is a noun or verb. When you think that this word is a noun or verb, that means this word gives the ambiguity, and this ambiguity is nothing but that is called the lexical ambiguity. Next, syntax level ambiguity. Here a sentence can be parsed in different ways. For example, he lifted the beetle with red cap. That means, did he use cap to lift the beetle, or he lifted a beetle that had red cap? Which means, in this example, the one sentence gives us two different meaning, which is called as a syntax level ambiguity. Next, referential ambiguity. In this ambiguity, referring to something using pronouns. For example, Rima went to Gauri. She said, "I am tired." Now look at this example. In this example, Sima went to Gauri. Then the next sentence is, "I am tired." Now in this sentence, "I am tired" means here, who is tired? Sima or Gauri? That means it gives us the ambiguity. And this ambiguity is nothing but that is called referential ambiguity. Next, one input can mean different meaning and many input can mean the same thing. That means in referential ambiguity, when one sentence meaning two different things or two different sentence means one thing. In this case, we call it as referential integrity. For all these ambiguity, the NLU is harder to understand. Next, steps in NLP. The NLP has basically five steps. First one is the lexical analysis, second one is the synthetic analysis, third one is semantic analysis, and fourth one is disclosure integration, and fifth one is thematic analysis. Now, we will discuss one by one. First, we discuss about the lexical analysis. Now, look at the lexical analysis. It involves identifying and analyzing the structure of words. That means basically in lexical analysis, it takes the input and from that input, it analyzes and identifies the word. Next, lexicon of a language means the collection of words and phrases in a language. And lexical analysis is dividing the whole chunk of text into paragraphs, sentence and words. Which means the main aim of lexical analysis is to take the whole text as input and from that text is divide this input text into paragraphs, sentence and words. Next, synthetic analysis or you can say it as parsing. It involves analysis of words in the sentence for grammar and arranging words in a manner that shows the relationship among the words. Which means in synthetic analysis, it takes the sentence and from that sentence, it checks the grammar and it also checks the relationship between the words. Then the sentence such as the school goes to boy is rejected by English synthetic analyzer. Because in this sentence, there is no relationship between the word. For this reason, this sentence is rejected by our English synthetic analyzer. Next, semantic analysis. It draws the exact meaning or the dictionary meaning from the text and the text is checked for meaningfulness. That means, in semantic analysis, it checks whether a sentence is a meaningful sentence or not. Next, it is done by mapping synthetic structure and object in the text domain. And the synthetic analyzer disregards the sentence such as hot ice cream. That means, in the sentence hot ice cream, this sentence has no meaning. Because ice cream is always cool. If you say that hot ice cream, that it means nothing. So that our semantic analysis always rejects this type of meaningless sentence. Next, discourse integration. Here, the meaning of any sentence depends upon the meaning of the sentence just before it. And in addition, it also brings about the meaning of the immediately succeeding sentence. That means in discourse phase here, the meaning of one sentence always depends upon the meaning of its previous sentence. And it also draws the meaning of its next sentence. Now the last step, that is pragmatic analysis. During this, what was said is reinterpreted on what is actually meant. It involves deriving those aspects of language which is required real world knowledge. In this analysis or in this step, it reinterprets the output with the input. That means it matches what is the input and what is its output, whether this output is correct or not. Next, advantages of NLP. First advantage is NLP helps users to ask questions about any subject and get a direct response within seconds. That means by using the NLP system, you can easily ask the question by using your own language or natural language and the NLP system can easily convert that language into the machine language so that the machine understood your question and give you the answer within a fraction of a second. Next, NLP offers exact answer to the question, means it does not offer unnecessary and unwanted information. Which means the NLP always gives us the particular answer without giving the unnecessary or unwanted things. Next one is NLP helps computers to communicate with the human in their language. That means by using the NLP, you can easily interact with the computer or with the robot, because this NLP converts your language into the computer understandable language, and it also gives the output that is in your natural language. Next, it is very time efficient, and most of the companies use NLP to improve the efficiency of documentation process, accuracy of documentation, and identify the information from language database. These are the advantages of our NLP system. Now look at the disadvantages of NLP. Here the first disadvantage is that NLP may not show context. And next one is NLP is unpredictable. And here NLP may require more keystroke, and it is unable to adapt to the new domain, and it has a limited function. Now look at the applications of NLP. Here the first application is question answering. In question answering, focuses on building system that automatically answer the question asked by human in a natural language. Which means in question answering system, here this system is basically used for giving you the answer of any question. Suppose you ask a question to the question answering system by using your own language or some natural language, then the system gives you the answer by using the natural language. This is the one application of our NLP system. Now look at the second application, that is spam detection. In this case, the spam detection is used to detect unwanted emails getting to a user's inbox. Now look at the figure. In this figure, suppose this is your mail or your inbox, and from that inbox, if there is some unwanted message, then the NLP takes that unwanted message into the spam, and which message are necessary messages that are not in spam, that means these messages are remain in your inbox. Now look at the next application, that is sentiment analysis. Here the sentiment analysis is also known as opinion mining. It is used on the web to analyze the attitude, behavior, and emotional state of the sender. This application is implemented through a combination of NLP and statistics by assigning the values to the text and identify the mood of the context. It means the sentimental analysis always analyzes the behavior and attitude of the user, and according to that, it gives us the output. Now look at this figure. This figure shows the different behavior and attitude of a human being. Next application is spelling correction. Microsoft Corporation provides word processor software like MS Word or PowerPoint for the spelling correction. Now look at this figure. In this figure, here there is a word that is embedded, and this word has a spelling mistake. When you perform a spelling mistake, then it gives a suggestion which contains the correct spelling of that word. That means the spelling correction system is a system which always gives you the correct spelling of a word. And this is basically used in MS Word or PowerPoint. When you use the word and write some text, if in that text you perform some spelling mistake, then it automatically show you correct spelling of that word. The next application is chatbot. Implementing the chatbot is one of the important application of NLP. It is used by many companies to provide the customers chat service. The next one is machine translation. Machine translation is used to translate text or speech from one natural language to another natural language. That means in machine translation system, here one natural language can be translated to other natural language. Next, difference between natural language and computer language. Here, the natural language has a very large vocabulary, whereas the computer language has a very limited vocabulary. And the next difference is natural language is easily understood by humans, and the computer language is easily understood by the machine. And third one is natural language is ambiguous in nature, whereas computer language is unambiguous. Here, the difference between natural language and computer language is that the computer language is understood by the computer and the natural language is easily understood by the human being. But when the human being wants to communicate with a computer, in this case, the computer must understood the natural language. But the computer only understood the computer language. For this reason, the NLP is used, which converts the natural language into the computer language, so that the computer can easily understood the natural language and gives the output or reply to the user by the natural language. This is all about the natural language processing. If you have any doubt regarding this natural language processing, then you can ask me through comment. I will discuss about your doubt. Thank you for watching.